Here is another lung. Notice, here's the pleural surface. Here's a cut surface. Here's some more pleural surface. Here is some fine subpleural stippling by anthracotic pigment, which is very common, almost to the point where I could say it's normal. And here's another cut surface. Notice in this portion of the cut surface is a consolidated yellowish area. If you were to take a microscopic view through this area, you would see that it looks like a large granuloma. And why is that? It's because it is a large granuloma. Here is some normal lung out at the periphery, and here is the inflamed necrotic granulomatous area involving the lung. Let's look at it a little bit higher. You can see that a large portion of the granuloma is necrotic, even from this power, in that you really cannot make out the outlines of the cells too well. And all you see are remnants of inflammatory cells. In this portion, you could see some remnant of bronchial mucosa. This is Wegener granulomatosis. It is a very serious necrotizing granulomatous destructive process in both the lower respiratory tract lung as well as upper respiratory tract, which has a very high mortality rate and is very poorly understood. And histologically, it can be described as a necrotizing granuloma. Two other features I would like to show you, however, that are part of Wegener's granulomatosis. Besides the fact that they have these nice multinucleated giant cells, is the fact that you have a vasculitis. Look at, here's a medium-sized blood vessel, and it is inflamed throughout its entirety. In fact, not only is it a vasculitis, but the blood vessels often become necrotic as well. So it is a necrotizing vasculitis. And here you can barely recognize the blood vessel because the wall appears to be almost completely necrotic, as in a fibrinoid type of necrosis. This is Wegener's granulomatosis, and thank you very much.